Painting something new doesn't have to be scary. I'm going to show you how I approach something new in this painting. So let's get started. So I've been having some fun painting these different china figures that I have and setting them up in humorous ways. So today what I wanted to do was get a Hostess snowball. I don't know if you remember these from childhood. They're a marshmallow treat with a chocolate bottom and coconut on top. Something I never liked as a kid, but visually very appealing. And I thought it would be funny to have penguins looking at a snowball and sort of asking each other, what's this? It's a big snowball, but of course not a white snowball, but indeed a sugary coconut snowball. But I've never painted a snowball before. And so I thought, all right, I have to put myself in the shoes of beginning again. Painting is a lot about beginning again all the time and remembering that everything is a shape. Now, what you will notice in my strategy here is I'm scared of the snowball. It's terrifying me, so I'm going to leave it for last. So that's, sort of one of those things like, well, when you have to do it, you're just going to do it. So I'm putting in my darks first, which I sort of like to do. And I don't use any masking fluid. If you watch this channel, you know that. And it's because I'm klutzy with it, not because I think it's a bad product. I think it's really great. So I'm working on my penguins and looking at anything that strikes me as being gray or slightly not white. And I did make a lot of color dabs on the upper left-hand side. I usually do to be sure of what my values are going to be. But this time I wasn't sure. And that's because what I left for last is the snowball. Now, normally, if I had been comfortable with something, I would have gone and done that first. All right, time for the snowball. Looking really carefully, you can get distracted by all the coconut on top and want to get involved in, you know, painting each one of those individual little dots. But that's kind of not going to work because everything is a shape. Everything has volume. Everything has mass. And so I thought, all right, you have to approach this way you approach everything. And that means finding the light parts of it and the medium parts of it and the dark parts of it. So that's what I did. But right now it's not looking much like a snowball and I'm feeling a little bit discouraged. So I'm going to go on my merry way and try to ignore the snowball because it's scaring me. So blocking everything else in, drying things, and not feeling like my color, I'm feeling like my values are pretty good, but the colors aren't bright enough. I'm going to come and adjust that with some additional layers, but not right now. Now I know that I just can't put off the snowball anymore. So I find some dark shadows that are happening from the candy cane and try to create some dots. And there's just no way you can create dots on something without it looking like you did it. So I thought, all right, I know what people do. I've watched people do snow. They flick the paintbrush at the thing and it will create all these little dots. Well, my paintbrush wasn't going to cooperate with that at all. There must be a special paintbrush to do that with. And if you know what that is, please let me know. So I did that for a little bit, but it didn't work very well. And so I did end up applying them by hand, trying as hard as I could to not make it look like it was man-made, but it happened from some sort of natural process. Now, natural process and Hostess cupcake thingy snowball don't go together in the same sentence at all. But slowly but surely, I felt like I've got everything blocked in pretty well, although I do think my snowball does need not defining, but some highlights. So I dry everything, making everything darker than it was before. That's usually the case. I start out with my darkest darks, but they usually have to be adjusted to being even darker. And I felt like this was pretty good where I was here, but I knew that I hadn't quite gotten it. So typically what I do is I go away and then I'll come back and it's as if you see something for the first time again. So I went away, I came back, and I applied some white gouache, and that's what's happening there. Now, some watercolor societies won't let you use white gouache. It's against the rules, but I needed it for those little bit of highlights that happened on the snowball. And once I got those in, I felt like I was pretty successful at making that snowball. And I'm titling this, That's a Big Snowball, because it amuses me. It's really good to find things that amuse you. You know, painting is fun and everything, but if you can amuse yourself at the same time, it's a lot better. So these are my penguins, and in a minute I'm going to show you the other penguin picture that I did where I just enjoy that little young penguin pointing out to his what I pretend are his parents. What a big present that is. I'm enjoying my little, what do you call it, fantasy life. So remember to keep the whites of your paper white, your paints wet, master value mix for color. Please join my YouTube channel. See you next time. Bye-bye.